Hi, I'm Justin from Maths Pathway. When I first became a teacher, I thought Excel would be a helpful thing to teach my students, and it is. What I didn't expect is how much time it could save me, particularly around report writing time. I'm not sure if you've been in a situation where you've got to write a report comment for each student. And really what you're drawing upon mostly with those comments is the sort of things that you've noted down in your gradebook. Like maybe you've already made some sort of, you know, very high to very low judgment about how their class participation has gone or their homework. And you need to write an individual report comment for each student. And although you might still want to personalize, Excel can actually do a whole lot of the work for us and give us a pretty good guess at a starting comment that we can then edit more quickly. I'll show you how to get this done. There's a few ingredients we'll need. One is to get a bit more information about each student and let Excel tell us. So we'll just insert a couple of columns so that we can work here. What I want to do is I want to use their first name in the report comment. I'd want to be able to say like Raffi does such and such. So I want to split out and get their first name. So I can do that using the data column. I can do text to columns, and I'm going to say that these are delimited via a space. So there's a space that breaks up the different parts of the name. Next, finish, there we go. And I've got my first names here and surnames there. So I'll just update my headings. The other thing I want to do in my report comments is use pronouns. I might want to say, Raffi does such and such, she is a great learner or something. So I'll put in an extra column where I'll put in their pronouns. Okay, so I've typed all those in. Let me get rid of these extra columns we don't need anymore. And now the final ingredient I need is what the options for the comments would be. So I've got them here in another sheet where I've set it up with very low to very high, and I've got comments ready to go. And now I can just use a formula to make the report comment for me. What I can do is first say, the first ingredient for the comment is going to be the student's first name. So I'll put equals their first name, ampersand, and then I'll do a space, because I'll need a space after their name. And then it'll be their comment about class participation. So I'll do a VLOOKUP. I will look up their class participation grade, high to medium low, in this table, which I'll dollar sign so that it doesn't move around when I move the reference around. I want column number 2. The first column is the one with the very low to very high stuff in it. And I want this to be an exact match, so I'll put in false. And let's see how the report comment is looking so far. Ayaz participates very well in class discussions overall, etc., because she's got high in that score. I want another sentence though. I don't just want one sentence, so this one ends in a full stop. So I'll put another space in. So that's quotation mark, space, quotation mark for putting a space. Another ampersand, and now I want the pronoun. So I'll pull that in, she, ampersand, space, ampersand. And then I'll get the other comment for the other value. So this one's gonna look at their homework score. It's gonna look it up in exactly that same table with the dollar signs again. This time it'll be column number 3 because it's the next one over. And again, I want an exact match, so I'd go false. And like magic, I have comments for each student that change automatically as a result of the grades that have been put in. So if anyone's proofreading my reports, they will never find a discrepancy between what's written in the comment and what's in the grade, because by construction, I've made that happen. And then, of course, I'd go through and read them one by one and make sure that they still match the student and maybe tweak a couple. But the majority are probably fine. Enjoy.